Hey guys, in this video I want to talk about how nutrition affects athletic performance. Now there's no surprise that there's a relationship between good nutrition and good overall health, and I'm going to explore in this video how it affects athletic performance in particular. Whether you're an athlete that's competing or just a weekend warrior in the gym, nutrition is going to be important for you regardless of what your focus is. As you improve your nutrition, you're going to see that your performance also is going to improve. You should have a wide spread of different nutrients such as whole grain breads, vegetables, fruit, lean meats, and low fat dairy. It's going to be most optimal for your body, and if you're an athlete or any type of fitness enthusiast, it's going to be necessary for your progression in the gym. So there's three macronutrients, protein, fats, and carbs, and your body requires a certain amount of each of these every single day. I can't tell you exactly what your body needs, but a good rough estimate for the average person would be around 35 to 40% of your calories coming from carbohydrates, 25 to 30% coming from protein sources, and around 30% coming from fats. If you are exercising strenuously, you might have to increase your overall caloric intake through increasing your carbohydrates. So carbohydrates, that's the main source of energy for the body. It's important that we have some before we do any type of athletic training if you want to have a sustained amount of energy for your workout. When you eat carbohydrates, the body breaks it down to what's called glucose. This is what provides your body with energy for your workouts. Glucose is the body's primary energy source. Glucose can also be converted into glycogen and stored in the liver and in your muscle cells. The reason it's stored in your muscle is so that while you're working out, you're able to tap into that glycogen storage and provide you with sustained energy. You can increase the glycogen storages in your muscles by increasing the amount of carbohydrates that you intake. You might notice after some form of a cheat meal that you got a better pump while you're in the gym, and this is because your muscles are going to be more full of glycogen. If you don't provide your body with enough carbohydrates, your body's going to find a way to sustain the energy. So this may involve breaking down your muscle tissues to use as fuel for your workout. And we don't want any of this. So it's important that you get adequate amounts of carbohydrates. Carbs are not essential like proteins and fats, but I find carbohydrates necessary for myself if I want to have a good workout. Whole grains should make up a good number of your overall carbohydrate intake for the day. This is things like whole grain wheats, brown rice, and whole grain cereals. And refined carbohydrates are things like white bread, white rice, and anything sugary. Refined carbohydrates are going to break down and enter the bloodstream a lot quicker. So if you're going to have any of these, it would be recommended to have it before, during, or after your workout. Then we get into what's called the glycemic index. And this is going to be a wide spectrum ranging from very processed foods all the way down to foods that aren't processed at all. The glycemic index references how fast your body breaks it down into glucose, has it readily available for use. It's recommended that you eat more of your low glycemic index foods and try to have your higher glycemic index foods around your training times when you're going to be readily using that energy that's going to be available. Having a pre-workout or pre-event meal is going to be important to ensure that you have really good performance while you're in the zone. A high carbohydrate meal 3 to 4 hours before any type of event is going to be most ideal. And if you're going into the gym, anywhere from 1 to 2 hours prior to your workout is going to be the best time to get your carbohydrates in. It depends person to person. Personally, myself, I can have a lot of carbohydrates and then go right to working out, whereas other people have a little bit more difficulties than they need a bit before they go into the gym. Carbohydrates typically are going to be digested a little bit better. You wouldn't want to have a high fat meal before you go into an athletic event or the gym. So to sum it up, before an event, you want to get your slow digesting carbohydrates in the morning, and then have more of your refined or quick digesting carbohydrates 1 to 2 hours before the event or gym time. Calories during exercise. So you might have seen this around the gym before. A bag of gummy worms open around the powerlifting squat racks. This is so that they get their sustained energy throughout their workouts. There's varying studies talking about the effectiveness of this, but if you find that it works for you, then by all means do it. And obviously if you're looking for weight loss, don't do that. But if you're working out for more than 60 minutes, this is where we start to burn off that muscle glycogen and have to start refilling our muscle stores with carbohydrates from food. Roughly around 30 to 60 grams of carbohydrates is all you need intra-workout. There are also supplements that provide quick acting carbohydrates for working out. You might see sport gels that you eat while you're working out. These are exactly that, just carbohydrates that are going to be quickly broken down and utilized for sports or any type of workout. This is why drinks like Gatorade are somewhat popular, as they're going to provide that for you. Now, as we get into talking about nutrients after your workout, this is where it's going to be really important. So right after a workout, when you beat up your muscles or after a sporting event, you want to increase your overall protein intake and your carbohydrate intake. And you'd like to do this roughly within the first hour after your workout. This is to top up the glycogen storages in your muscles, and you can replenish this by having more of your higher glycemic index foods or the higher processed foods that are going to break down and get into your bloodstream a little bit quicker. You're also going to want to get protein post-workout, and this is going to go alongside your carbohydrate intake, as carbohydrates are going to spike your insulin, which will tell your body's cells to suck up as much protein as it can get into it. The amount of protein that your body needs post-workout is going to be different from person to person. A scoop of protein powder is going to give you more than enough. I like to take 2 scoops of protein powder, but again, everyone is different. And we'd also get into the topic of supplements for your nutrition. If you have a really good diet, you're going to meet most of your nutritional needs and won't have to supplement. But life's pretty fast-paced and difficult. Not everyone's going to be able to get that in. That's where supplements shine. Supplements shouldn't make up the basis of your nutrition. They should only do what their name implies, supplement it. Supplements will usually only benefit you if you're deficient in whatever you're supplementing with. So people that are low in iron are going to obviously benefit from supplementing with iron, but your doctor will advise you on that. Using supplements are going to be convenient, but a little bit less cost effective than using whole foods to get your nutrition in. Supplements include things like vitamins, carbohydrate drinks, protein shakes, protein bars, BCAAs, EAAs, fat burners, caffeine, the list goes on. The ones that I view as being effective are things like your protein powders, creatine, and pre-workout caffeine. One last point to touch on is your overall water intake. So that kind of falls under the umbrella of nutrition, but dehydration is going to cause you to be more likely to injure yourself, decrease your overall performance. Water is essential to the body, so we want to get a good amount of it. Drink plenty of fluids prior to, during, and post-workout. That's going to be your best friend for ensuring your overall performance and safety. Sometimes water is not enough. If you're sweating a lot doing an outdoor event, you might need to invest in something like a sports drink such as Gatorade to help out with replenishing electrolytes such as sodium and potassium. As when you're sweating, you're going to sweat out a lot of these electrolytes. So overall, good nutrition is going to help your athletic performance because you're using it as your fuel for your workouts or your event. You want to opt for more of your unrefined carbohydrates or whole grains. Those are going to be your best sources of energy. Make sure you get your carbohydrates and proteins post-workout to replenish your muscle glycogen, as well as allow your muscles to start recovering. And don't forget to drink your water. If you found this video useful, hit that subscribe button below to see more content like this, and I'll see you guys next time.